Assalamualaikum kids, I hope you are doing great. Okay students, so before starting my new lesson, I would like to give a brief recap of the previous lesson. In our previous lesson, we have studied some metallic minerals, and I told you that Pakistan is not blessed with the huge amount of the metallic minerals, unlike the non-metallic mineral. The metallic minerals, just like the chromite, copper, and iron ore, can be found in other countries. Some other minerals include the manganese, can also be found. Power resources. There are the different power resources that exist in our country, just like petroleum, oil fields, and the natural gas. Pakistan is not among of those countries, just like the Gulf and the Middle East country, including the Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Iran, Iraq, who have the large reserves of the oil. But we are in those countries who usually import oil from the Gulf countries and the Middle States and use them. And among the oil we have imported from the other countries, 50% of that oil is usually used in running our vehicles, including the buses, cars, etc. Then we have oil fields too, in some area of the Lower Sindh, and 60% of the population have got the oil from Lower Sindh. Oil refineries, as we cannot use the raw material of the oil that we get directly from the Lower Sindh, so there are also oil refineries for that purpose, that usually refine the oil that we can use them for the domestic purposes. Natural gas. Pakistan is very fortunate to have the large reserves of the natural gas at the place of the Sui in Balochistan, but the more important thing is, as we have the large reserves, so we should not waste it. We should not let it leak, as it will cause the fatal or the fires. Let's move on to today's topic. Today's topic is electricity. Oh, the nightmare. As we already know that we do not have the sufficient amount of the energy resources regarding the electricity in our country. That's where we always face the problem. Since my childhood, I can see that I can witness the problem of the load shedding in our country. So let's see why it's a problem. One of the main reason is that the non-sufficient dams, because we do not have the sufficient dams to reserve the water. Though we have a huge season of the monsoon, but usually that all the water will be resulted in the flood, and we cannot save them because we do not have the sufficient amount of the dams. That's why every government that comes into the democracy always emphasize on the establishment of the dams, but unfortunately up till yet we have not been able to provide our country the sufficient amount of the electricity. Let's read it out. Pakistan does not produce enough electricity for our needs, no doubt, so we have to import electricity. Okay, electricity in Pakistan is produced in three ways: thermal, many हाइडल एंड न्यूक्लियर. न्यूक्लियर से की जाती है, हाइडल पानी से की जाती है, थर्मल से की जाती है. करंटली ड्यू टू पावर क्राइसिस इन पाकिस्तान, ऑल सिटीज एंड द विलेजेस हैव टू फेस द लोड शेडिंग. I can tell you that since my childhood, I was born in 1992, I can still witness the problem of the load shedding, and I really pray that someday our country will overcome this problem. This is not only affects the daily day-to-day life of people, but also affects the productivity in industries and business activities. Obviously, if you do not have electricity, how will you take your online classes? If you do not have electricity, how will you run your factories and industries in the country? So your productivity will be less. Electricity is very, very important thing for the productivity. Having a non-stop supply of electricity is also important in hospitals. Obviously, aapko operation ho raha aur light chali jaye, so that would be very bad. And educational institutions. During the summer, the extreme heat in Pakistan becomes unbearable, making children and older people suffer. Can you think of the things that cannot be done when there is no electricity in your house? Obviously, there are a lot of things we cannot do without the electricity. Your mother cannot do the washing, clothes. You cannot cook the food in microwave oven. You cannot watch the TV. Even sometimes, because our Wi-Fi's are usually connected with the electricity, they need electricity power. So usually, you cannot take the classes. Other sources of power. Thus, to meet the need of a rapidly growing population, as you know that the population of Pakistan is increasing day by day. So, to meet their needs, more power are required to run the industries, residents, hospitals, education institutions, and commercial buildings. Pakistan, like other countries of the world, is trying to develop the alternative energy to meet these demands. Aisa nahi hai ki Pakistan chup karke baitha hua hai. Our country, our democracy, our government is trying continuously to make the other alternatives of the electricity. Alternative energy means energy which is produced from the sources other than the water. For example, wind energy, solar energy. Solar energy is the best source of the production of energy. You do not need the other thing. It's a very natural way, by the way. आजकल तो ये घरों में भी बड़ी इजीली अवेलेबल है जी, सबने लगाए हुए हैं. पाकिस्तान इज करंटली डेवलपिंग विंड पावर प्लांट्स इन झम्पीर, घाड़ो, केटी बंदर एंड बिन कासिम इन सिंध. ओके, दैट्स अ गुड प्रोजेक्ट. विंड एनर्जी, विद द हेल्प ऑफ विंड एनर्जी वी यूजुअली develop the electricity. We use some solar energy too. It should be possible for us to develop many more solar and wind energy units as the source of these forms of energy is available free and in abundant quantity. As these are the natural resources, students, sunlight and the wind are provided. Allah Ta'ala blessed us with the huge amount of the sunlight and huge amount of the wind. No one can control us. It has no cost. So that's why they are the free things. For example, there is a lot of sunshine in Pakistan. Even our shortest day is 9.5 hours long. Even in winters, our shortest day is 9.5 hours long. That's a huge amount of the sunlight. So that can be used. We should not waste it, because these all are the resources that Allah Ta'ala blessed us. So we should take advantage of that. However, the cost of the generation of electricity in these ways is high because their equipment, their tools are very costly and requires lots of investment. Biogas. Biogas derived from the animal waste, cow dung on farms, was first introduced in a small way in 1974. So biogas is usually the production way of for production the electricity that was discovered in 1974 with the help of the wastage of animals. The national program was launched in 1980 to 1981. By 1985 to 1986, more than 4,000 biogas units were in operations, mostly in rural areas. But most of them have been closed now. So biogas is a very good way, but it is not that very famous way to produce electricity. But we should consider it. So that's all from today's lesson, students. If you have any other query regarding this, please feel free to ask. Thank you, everyone.